Hi guys, today me, Günel Alekberova, my group mates Sabina Tanukova and Prane Mahmudzadeh will explain you the composition of Boolean function by its variables. Let's begin. First, I would like to begin with simple examples. For example, we have x over sigma, and if our sigma is equal to 0, then we write it like this form. If our sigma is equal to 1, then we write this in this form. And the composition of Boolean function by these variables. We can decompose any Boolean function given to us, for example, f, x1, x2, xn, by less than or equal to the n. Our minimum number of decomposed variables must be 1, maximum number of decomposed variables can be n. For the Boolean function f, x1, x2, xn, we can write this Boolean function in this form. F sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma k, and x k plus 1 till x n. And the composition of a Boolean function is the conjunction of the disjunction. Let's move to the full disjunctive normal form. For any Boolean function different from contradiction can be written like this. F x1 x2 till the xn. In the full disjunctive normal form, we decompose the Boolean function by all variables. Is equal to or x1 sigma 1, x2 sigma 2, xn sigma n, f sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma n, such that for sigma 1, sigma 2, till sigma n, our function f sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma n is equal to 1. Why like this? Because at the beginning of my speech I said that for any Boolean function different from contradiction. In this part we take only functions that that is equal to 1. And if we have contradiction, our function will always will be equal to 0. Therefore, we don't take the Boolean function which is contradiction. And full conjunctive normal form. Full conjunctive normal form is disjunction of the conjunctions. And this form has the form of fx1, x2, xn is equal to x1 over sigma 1, x2 over sigma 2, xn over sigma n, f sigma 1, sigma 2, till sigma n. Here, for sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma n, such that f sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma n is equal to 0. It is the simple short information about the composition of any Boolean function.
As you know, in the previous part of the video, our groupmate Günel Alekberova explained how to the theory of decomposition of Boolean functions. And now I will show you just some simple example how to decompose a given function like this by its all variables. So let's get started. Our function is given like that, x or y, and it implies z. And I have already drawn the truth table, so let's start. As you know, we write, we decompose the function by its all combinations. So let's take first combination, 0, 0, 0. And if it's 0, we write x on the x, y, on 0 on y, and 0 on z. So we will continue it in the same way for a second combination, f of 0, 0, 1, x, 0, s, y, 0, z, 1. Or third combination, f of 0, 1, 0, x, 0, y, 1, z, 0, or f of next combination is 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, x, 0, y, 1, and z, or 1, or this combination, f of 1, 1, 1, x, 1, x, 1, y, 0, z, 0. So, and the value of f of 0, 0, 1 gives us 1. How did I find it? So, 0 XOR 0 gives us 0. 0 implies 0 is true. So, the value of this combination is 1. So, we take it as 1 and we multiply it with the second part. And as Günel told, x over 0 gives us not x, and y over 0 again not y. And if it's z over 1, we write it at z. Sorry, I forgot this part. So again, the same. Or 1 times this part, not x, not y, not z. So let's continue in the same way. So this part gives us 0. As it gives us 0, when we multiply it, it will automatically make it 0, so we can cancel it out. So this part, f 0, 1, 1, it gives us 1. 1 times this, not x, y, z. Or again, 1, 1, 1 gives us 1 times this part, x, y, z. Or this part gives us 1, 1, 0 gives us 1. Or x, y, not z. Or, and this part gives us 1, 1 times expression, and this gives us 0, so even we don't write it, we can cancel out. And this is the decomposition of a given expression by its all variables, and we call it full DNF.
Before me, Sabina, as you see, show an example of full DNF, but I want to show you another example with two variables. How we can simplify the expression with two variables. So let's begin. So we have a function like x implies y implies z. So we write this line. As previous part, Sabina explained you how we write this line. She used all variables integration because of full DNF. But I only write decompose with two variables and kept the z the same. But what we do write instead of z, so I show you now. We write x over 0 x negation by negation, and instead of z, I will write with using truth table and concentration our function, 0 implies 0 implies z, so or x negation y and 0 imply 1 imply z. Then, in order to simplify our equation, we write x negation y negation, and what we write instead of this bracket. This bracket gives us 1, y 1, because as we know, 0 implies everything gives us 1. And the next one gives us also one, and the third one also gives us one, and we write x y negation. So the last bracket gives us z, so we write x y z. And as you see, I decompose the given function with two variables. Thanks for watching.